गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट टुडे. सो आर टुडेज क्लास विल बी ऑन कैपिटल गेन्स. सो कैपिटल गेन्स इज अ फोर्थ हेड. फर्स्ट लेट मी राइट हियर. सो आर टुडेज कॉन्सेप्ट इज न्यू चैप्टर, दैट्स कैपिटल गेन्स, एंड वी हैव डन विद दैट हाउस प्रॉपर्टी चैप्टर. सो कैपिटल गेन्स चैप्टर, दिस इज अ फोर्थ हेड. ओके, सो वी नो वी हैव फाइव हेड्स ऑफ इनकम, राइट? वी हैव फाइव हेड्स ऑफ इनकम. फर्स्ट इज अ सैलरी, नेक्स्ट इज हाउस प्रॉपर्टी, थर्ड इज पीजीबीपी, फोर्थ इज कैपिटल गेन्स, एंड फिफ्थ इज आईएफओएस. ओके, सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कैपिटल गेन्स नाउ. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कैपिटल गेन? ओके, सो फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कैपिटल गेन. ओके, सो नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ गेन. गेन मीन्स प्रॉफिट. ओके, इन टैक्स लैंग्वेज वी से गेन, एंड वी इन अकाउंटिंग लैंग्वेज वी आर सेइंग दैट गेन एज प्रॉफिट. ओके, so when do we get profit? We get profit when we sell any asset. Sale of asset. Okay, we are selling the asset. What we are doing? We are selling the asset. Next, what we'll do? We'll deduct the cost of asset. If we get the amount in positive, then it will be called as gain. Okay, let's take example. With the example we'll understand. Okay, so we are saying in capital gains chapter, we are saying the gain, there should be a gain. How to get gain? Gain we get profit. How we get profit? Sale minus cost equal to gain. Yeah, we can say profit. Okay, so we have to sell asset. Which asset we have to sell? Capital asset. Okay, so we have to sell a capital asset. To get a gain in this chapter, we have to sell capital asset. Okay, so when do we have to sell? We have to sell in the previous year. Okay, take example. Here I have a motor car. I have some house property. Okay, I purchase this house property, for example, 5 lakh rupees. Example. And within 1 year, this property I purchased, and within 1 year I sold the house property. So we can say this is cost of acquisition. COA I have written here. Cost of acquisition. How much? 5 lakhs. So what I am doing now, from this I have to deduct sale value. So I sold this asset for 10 lakhs. Take example. Within 1 year this has done. In 1 year it has happened. In 1 year only it happened. I purchased a house property for 5 lakhs and the same property I sold for rupees 10 lakhs. Within a year I sold. Okay. Now how much is the profit? Profit is how much? Easily we can say, right? From 10 lakhs is sale, deduct from sale cost of acquisition. You get how much? 5 lakhs. So how much is profit? 5 lakhs. So profit is 5 lakhs. Okay? Easy. It's very easy. So in this chapter, what we have to study now, what we have to focus, what we have to cover, that we'll see. So what we are saying first, there should be a house property. Okay. There should be not house property, there should be a capital asset. There should be a capital asset, and that asset should be sold. When it has to be sold? It has to be sold during the previous year. We know what is the previous year. For us, previous year is 1920. Okay, so we have to sell the asset in the previous year, that is 1920. Okay. So now first we'll understand when the gain or profit is charged under the head capital gains. So we are saying this capital gains is the fourth head. Fourth head of income. Okay, so if any capital asset is sold during the previous year, what we are saying, if any capital asset is sold during the previous year, and if on that sale if there is any gain or profit, that will be taxed under capital gains chapter. Okay, so let us understand first how to get gain. There should be what? First there should be how to get gain. So there is a section called the chargeability section, charging section. So we have section 45. So what is section 45? This section is saying charging section. We call this as charging section. When the income will be taxed under capital gains, okay? So the charging section is saying, section 45 is saying, if any SSE is having what? Capital asset. If any SSE is having what? Capital asset. Okay, and that capital asset he has to sell the capital asset. We can say sale or transfer. What we are saying, SSE should have a capital asset. and that capital asset he has to sell. We have seen here like this. Okay, now if you sell the asset, there is no not always we get profit, we get loss also. So what we are saying, we have to get some profit slash gain also we get. So we are saying if a partner, if a SSC is having a capital asset and that is if sold, he will get either profit or gain. If we get profit, that will be called as deemed income. That will be called as deemed income. Okay, and that will be taxed under taxable under capital gains chapter. Capital gains chapter. Okay, it's easy, very easy. What we are saying, charging section means this section is saying if any SSC is selling capital asset, if he is selling what capital asset, okay, and on that capital asset, if we get profit, that profit will be called under this chapter as income, and that on that income, this will be taxable. See here example. See, house property is a capital gain, yes, and he is selling, he sold the asset, he got profit, and this will be called as income under H. This will be called as income under capital gains chapter. And it will, this will be taxed, easy. So we are saying in this chapter, if any capital asset is sold during the previous year, and on that if he earns the profit, that profit or gain will be called under this chapter as deemed income, and that it will be taxable under capital gains chapter. Okay. What if there is a loss? There will be a loss also, right? There is no guarantee in business that always we, if we sell any property, there will be always. There is no chance of, there is not compulsory profit. There may be a loss also. See, if there is a loss, so first what we'll do, we'll compute under the head capital gains. We'll take that loss under the head capital gains, and that loss we can set off and carry forward. Set off and carry forward. Okay, so what is set off and carry forward? I'll explain you. Yeah, very easy. I'll explain you what is the meaning of set off of carry forward. We have a separate chapter on this. So when we discuss the chapter, that time I'll explain what is set off and carry forward. Easy, very easy. So next, what we are saying again in this section, we are saying that asset should be sold in the previous year. So in the previous year, the sale should be previous year. The sale should take place. Sale or transfer we can take place when that it should be sold out in the previous year, it should be happened. Okay, easy. Chali, so it's easy. We are saying that if any capital asset is sold by the SSC during the previous year, on that if he is earning what profit or gain, that will be taxed under the chapter called capital gains. Easy. Now our first headache is what? To understand what is the meaning of capital asset. So first headache for us, the first headache is what? We have to understand first what is the meaning of capital asset under capital gains chapter. Okay, so for this there is a section. So everything we have a section. So we should first understand what is a capital asset. First we should know what is a capital asset, and we have to identify that capital asset. So I'm writing here capital asset. Section is 2, subsection 14. What is this saying? Okay, so we are saying capital asset means, first we have to know what is the meaning of capital asset. We are saying capital asset means, okay, so we are saying capital asset means any property of any kind. We are saying property of any kind, property of any kind held by, who is having this property? Held by SSC means he is having this property. Who is having this property? SSC is having this property. Whether or not connected with his business or profession. Business or profession. So we are saying if any SSC is having a property which is used in his business or not used in his business, that will be called as property. That will be called as capital asset. So we are saying if any property is used by, held means he is having, who is having? SSC. SSC meaning, we know the meaning of SSC. SSC means is a person who is earning income and is liable to pay tax. That person is called as what? SSC. So I am writing here liable to pay tax. Okay. In accounting language, we say, in taxation language, we say SSC means a person who is liable to pay tax. That person will be called as SSC. Okay, so the SSE is having some property. Either the property is connected to his business or not connected to his business. It's not concern. Okay, so what is important? There should be some property the SSE should have. Okay, next, one more point I'm writing here. This is important. B point. See, any securities. Again, I'll explain what is the meaning of securities. It's very easy. Securities means what? Shares, debentures, bond. I'll explain this later. The meaning of securities. Okay. On this we have to do some analysis. That analysis I'll do later. Are you?